Hi guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are going to be covering all three of the brand new Huda Beauty Neon Obsessions palette. If you watch my channel, you would know I am obsessed with the Obsessions palettes from Huda Beauty. So if you're interested in hearing my thoughts on these, as well as seeing three tutorials with these, then just keep watching. So these palettes released a couple of weeks ago, and a lot of you guys were asking if I was going to pick these up and asking me to review these, and you guys know I had to come through with this review. I did buy them when they came out. It's just taken me some time to get through filming the actual review part, but today's video I'm just going to go through real live tutorials and my thoughts on them as I apply them. So these are available right now on the Sephora website. They are $29 each. Just so you know, these are made in China. The regular palettes I do not believe are made in China, but the Obsessions palettes are made in China. These have really neat packaging. They are very different from the regular Obsessions palettes. They are much nicer packaging wise. You have a plastic cover versus the cardboard, and these are extremely cute. They say neon on top. I will say there is nothing that says the name on here, so I had to look them up. So this one is the neon green Obsessions one, and it doesn't say the word neon green. Though you would think I would know that this is neon green, but like, I didn't want to sound stupid and guess, so I had to look it up just in case I was wrong. And it's like a clear plastic too, and I just think I love this packaging. I believe these are a couple dollars more than the original Obsessions palette, but that would make sense because these have beautiful packaging. Online, this is described as a range of neon pressed pigment palettes inspired by Huda's obsessions for neon colors, offering versatile looks from subtle to vivid and colorful. So each of these palettes have a mixture of shimmers and mattes. So the first one that we have here is the neon pink. This one looks a little bit more purpley pinky. In this one, you get 4 shimmers and 5 mattes. And again, from purple to pink to lavenders are in this one. The next one that we have, which is on my eyes right now, is the neon orange one. This one, I feel like my eyes look like lemonade and I love it. But this one has more peachy, orangey, pinky, in that kind of family range. Really, really beautiful. This one reminds me of like real life highlighters. Absolutely beautiful. In this one you get 3 shimmers and then 5 mattes. And then the last one that we have here is the neon greens. This one I think is the most unique of the three. In this one you are getting 6 shimmers, which is way more than the other ones, and then 3 mattes, and this one definitely has the most unique shimmers. So if you like the shimmer formula, you're really going to like this, but this one is really neat as well. So I'm just going to stop talking and we are going to get into the tutorials, starting off with the neon pink. Okay, so first palette that we are going to play with is the neon pink Obsessions. This one is going to look like this. Pinks and purples, I am all for it. So I've already done one eye, so I can really tell you what I'm thinking of this. So I'm taking a Wingoss number 16 brush, and we're gonna dip it into this kind of neon lavender shade, and that's gonna go in the inner half of our crease. Now this shade starts off pretty sheer, as you can see. I think this is a really nice thing. I think it's going to be really pretty as just a wash of color on the lid. But if you do want the color a little bit deeper, you definitely are going to have to build her up. So next I'm taking the number 1 brush from Refer, and I'm going to take this shade right here. Now this one looks a little bit more purple in the pan, but as you can see, it comes off a lot more pink. So I'm just putting that in the center. And then to finish off the crease, I'm taking this neon hot pink color. And I'm very surprised at how pigmented this shade is. I think they did a very good job making this a neon pink. Like, it's pretty neon. This is with a blending brush. With a shader brush, it's definitely going to be that much more pigmented. So if you were looking for a neon, you found it. This is a really nice neon. I'm actually not a huge fan of neons, but yeah, that's a neon. But I'm really excited about the lavender shade. Once we get into the shimmers, these are actually, in this particular palette, I would consider to be more of a lid topper. I personally don't love that about these. They are really pretty. I think if you put these down as the base color and then these lid toppers on top. They are beautiful. For this look, I created kind of a cut crease, and I just feel like those colors didn't sit very well on top of the concealer. I think they would sit better on top of a glitter glue, or like I stated before, on top of just an all-over matte color with the lid topper to add a little extra pizzazz. Okay, so next I'm taking a Refer number 2 brush, and I'm going to dip into the hot pink shade in the corner. Now, of the shimmer shades, this one is definitely the most pigmented, but you do kind of have to dig into it a little bit and press it onto your lid. If you don't press it into the lid, you'll get chunks all over your face. So honestly, this formula really isn't my favorite. It takes a little bit of effort to work with. But then you put it down and it's like really pretty, so. Then I'm flipping my brush over and then I'm using the lightest shade right here, just on the inner part. Again, you still are going to need to press that into the lid. So just this working on top of that concealer. I'm not too crazy about, but then it is really pretty. On my lower lash line, I'm just gonna take the pinks and I'm going to run them along my lower lash line. So these palettes are definitely all about the neon shades, so you're not going to get much depth with your looks in this palette, but you are obviously just gonna get a lot of color. So it's not about depth or really flattering the eyes, if you will, just working with the basic shadows of your eyes. It's more about that color, so just be aware of that. These do show up really nice. So I am going to finish up this look and I will meet you back to give you my final thoughts on the neon pinks palette. So this is the final look that we created with the neon pink palette. So I just applied some mascara. I really like these neon colors and just using mascara so that the eyeshadow really pops, because they are neon after all. So my overall thoughts on this palette is I feel like some of these colors are going to require a little bit of a building to get the desired pigmentation that you want, which I personally like. I would prefer a shadow that is buildable as opposed to overly pigmented, especially since these are such bold colors. I would say this is a neon palette. Like, these shades are legitimately neon. Not every single shade in here is neon, but they are definitely very bright and eye-catching. I love this shade right here. I think it is the perfect amount of pigmentation. Now, what I'm not too crazy over is the lid toppers. They are really beautiful, so once you put them on your lid, like, they are beautiful, but I feel like they just are a little bit harder to work with. They are a little bit more chunky, so you definitely need to use your finger to kind of melt in and push in the product to your eyelid a little better. Glitter glue is not gonna hurt, but yeah, using a shader brush, you're gonna have to definitely dig into the pan to really get it to stay on your brush and not all over your face. So I think that this formula over here, it's just not my favorite. You have to put in a little extra love to get it to work, but once it's on there, it is beautiful. This palette does not have a lot of depth, but that's not what these palettes are meant for. They're just to create bright, pretty. Of the three palettes, this one is definitely the most monochromatic. I like this palette, I don't love it. So let's move on to the next palette. Alright, so now it's time to move on to the second one, which is the neon oranges. So I'm going to start off with a Morphe E27, and we're going to start off with this light orangey peachy shade right here. And this is just going to go in the inner half of my crease. Now I'm going to use very similar styles in all of these palettes just because this is the best way to really get the most out of the colors. I really like this color. I think it is a great transition color for this palette. The next shade that I'm going into is this one right here. Now, this one is kind of like that one in the neon pinks palette where it looks a little bit more purple and then you put it on. And as you can see, this is a very bright pink shade. But I do have to say, these two shades, don't they just go together perfectly? As you can see, these are actually very easy to work with and they're blending out super easy too. Only thing with this color is it just turns out so much more pink than it looks in the pan. Now I'm taking the Morphe M433 and I'm going to go into the yellow shade right here. So for the yellow shade, I'm just lightly going to pop this like right in that, almost the inner corner of my eye. Just right in this area that's left over, and that brings a lot of fun yellow to the look. And this one, just like the yellow in the neon pinks, is very buildable, so you can start it off soft or you can really build it up. So now it's time to play with the shimmers. Same thing with the neon pink I mean, they're more of lid toppers. I'm starting off with this color right here. I think this color would look really great layered on top of this color or even the orange, but I'm kind of putting it mostly on bare lid just so you can see. And this color is one of my favorite shimmers in these palettes. I think it is so beautiful. I do think that it could use a more colorful base to it, but the shimmer of it is just so gorgeous. And then I went in with this color right here, which is a little bit more orangey, very sheer. And then we're gonna finish with the shiny hot pink in this palette. All these shimmers are really kind of running the same. They're really, really pretty. They aren't my favorite formula in the world, but I mean, you can't lie. Like, they look so good on the lid. Now, taking a Morphe M562, we're gonna hop into this neon bright pink color. And this is just gonna go all the way on my lower lash line just to blend that in. And this color isn't too much different from the color in the crease. It is slightly more pink, as you can see, but just barely. And then the last color that I'm going to go in with is this color right here, and I love this color. So I'm just using a bullet brush, and we're just gonna put that all the way around the inner corner. So this is a look. I'm gonna finish off with lashes and lips and the rest of my face, and I will be right back. All right, so I'm back. This is the completed look. I have to say, I really, really like the neon orange one. I like it more than the hot pink one. I just like the type of looks that I can create, and I really, really am digging this whole look that I have going on. So overall, pretty consistent quality. It's a buildable formula. They are quite bright on the eyes. I think this one is going to be super fun for the summer. I find it to be a little bit more versatile than the neon pink one, and I think it has better fun colors, honestly. So I'm loving the neon orange. Same type of shimmer formula. I'm assuming that's also going to be with the other one, but this one is gorgeous. There is no type of depth in this palette, but that's not what these palettes are about. But I am loving this one. So now let's move on to the next one. All right, so now we are going to pop on to the neon green palette. The neon pink look I filmed on another day, and neon orange I just filmed and took off my eye makeup, and I have very sensitive eyes. So my eyes are red because I tried a look with this palette before and I absolutely hated it. Okay, so this is attempt one with the neon green palette. No, I need to try this again. But so I decided to keep this second one very simple because the first look I did, I was just trying to play with the colors, but this one I'm actually going to create a look that I really wanted to create. So let's zoom you in. So I put a little bit of powder there, and I'm going to start off with the lightest kind of light highlightery color in here. And I really like this shade. I think it's very complimentary to the neon family. No, but I really do like this shade. It is quite sheer, like you can see your skin underneath. But it's also a really soft neon, so if you want to add like a really soft neon to your face, you might like this. But I'm just using that kind of as my base color, and then we're gonna go in with kind of the standout matte here, and I'm just gonna kind of start blending that basically all over the eyelid. It seems what's really popular with the neon trend right now is just having one kind of monochromatic neon color on your eyelid, so that's what I'm testing out. This is, again, not the most pigmented, so it does take some building up if you really want it to show up. I would recommend, if you want it to show up the best and most neon, put a white base underneath. That's gonna make a world of difference, but I really just wanted to show you kind of what the shadow can do without having to be doctored like that. And as you can see, it is pretty neon. I feel like this isn't going to have the longest lasting power, but it is really nice. Now I'm going to take a bullet brush, and I'm gonna take this color. So this color is super chunky, kind of struggling to get something to show up. So yeah, I'm really digging into the pan. Okay, that showed up, but that's because I like broke into the pan and dug in, so I really don't like that middle shade. It took a lot and it's very chunky. You definitely need to use your finger to kind of press in there, and even then it's not the best. And I'm going to take just a touch of this yellow shade, which is much nicer, much more soft. I'm just going to put a touch of that in here. So I don't know if you can tell, but chunking up a little bit. and I do not like that. This shimmer formula really is not the best that it could be. Okay, but anyways, this look is super simple, so I'm just gonna put on some mascara and I will be right back. All right, so I just finished the look. This seems to be kind of a trendy look for the summer where you just add a pop of neon on the lid and then mascara. Some pulled it off better than me. A lot better than me, but I did just kind of want to try that trend out. So really quickly, I'm going to talk about the neon greens, and this had potential to definitely be my favorite of the three. However, it just did not perform up to how I would have liked it to perform. So this one is definitely my least favorite. Just because I really am not crazy about the shimmers in here. They're pretty, but they really aren't all that. A couple of the shimmers in here are really chunky, and I really struggled to get them on my lid, and they just ended up like all over my face. The saving grace in this palette is this color right here, because it's the statement color of this palette. It is the trendy color this summer, so that's the reason why I will be keeping this palette. This color is also very nice, and so is this. The light pink is nice, but I feel like it's kind of random. I don't know. It is random, but it goes better with the shimmers than these do. But yeah, I'm just really not crazy about this palette. This shimmer fell all over my face. It is extremely chunky. This one right here is another chunky shade. This one is really, really pretty, and so is this one, and so is this one. They're pretty, but they're very, very soft. There's almost no pigmentation to them, and these are going to be pretty just soft all over the lid with this light pink in the crease, but it's a really soft look. There's not much depth to it at all, and you can barely see the color on your eyelids. So though these are extremely pretty, they just aren't all that to me. They're not my favorite. So I definitely hate to say bad things about this, but it really is not my favorite. It has some nice qualities to it, but I just think the others have more to offer. This palette for me, I just feel like I can't create that many looks with. It's kind of a you pick one color and that's the look you have kind of palette, and it's just not. So my overall opinions on these palettes is that they are good. I don't think they are great by any means. I think they are super fun for the summer. They are very, very trendy, so I think you guys are definitely going to like them. I would say if you are going to pick up one, I definitely would recommend the neon oranges. I just feel like this one you can create the most versatile and different looks with. This palette allows you to create many looks. You can go in a lot of different directions with it, and I honestly feel like the quality in this is better than the quality in the other ones. I really think that might have to do with the matte to shimmer ratio, just because the mattes are good in all three of these. I think they are a beautiful buildable formula, so you can go from a sheer wash of color to really building it up to get that neonness, as well as adding a white base underneath that's going to take the neon to another level. So I really like the versatility that these mattes have, but I really do not think they did very good with the shimmers. They are pretty and there's a place for them, but they're more lid toppers, and though I do love lid toppers, they are all lid toppers, and I think that we needed a little bit more variety of some more pigmented shimmers. Lid toppers, they don't work so well on the lid alone. You do need to layer them. They are toppers. I mean, they're gorgeous, but there's just too many of them. We needed a little bit more from those shimmers. I think, you know, adding two regular shimmers and then a lid topper is fine, but I just don't like that they went all lid toppers and mattes. My personal opinion. I did also really like neon pinks. Be aware that the purples do pull very pink on the eyes, but if you were looking for a neon pink eyeshadow palette, I think this one is lovely, and the lid toppers that they have are gorgeous. You guys know I love a good purpley pink shade, and neon green, just for me, it wasn't my favorite. I don't like the lid topper formula, and that is 6 of the 9 shadows in here, and then also the mattes are just kind of blah, except for this one. So overall, these are good. I don't think they are great. I personally prefer the regular Obsessions palette, except for this one. This one's really good, the orange one. So I hope you guys found this review and tutorial video helpful. Let me know your thoughts down below, and I hope you guys take the time to subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys, have a good one.